My dear doctor, I place myself in your hands. Do with me what you like. I'm going to tell you my state of mind very frankly, and you will judge whether it isn't better to have me taken care of for a little while in a sanatorium, rather than leave me prey to the hallucinations and sufferings that are plaguing me. I was living like everybody else, looking at life with the open but blind eyes of man, without any surprise, without understanding. I was living as animals live, as we all live, carrying out all the duties of existence, examining and thinking I saw, thinking I knew, thinking I was familiar with surroundings, when one day I perceived that everything is false. It was a phrase from Montesquieu that suddenly illumined my thinking. Here it is. One more organ, or one less in our body, would give us a different intelligence. In fact, our organs are the only intermediaries between the exterior world and ourselves. That is to say, the inner being which constitutes the ego is in contact by means of a few nerve endings with the exterior being which constitutes the world. Uncertain, because since our senses number only five, the field of their investigations and the nature of their revelations are both quite limited. I will explain. The eye transmits dimensions, shapes, and colors to us. It deceives us on these three points. It can reveal to us only objects and beings of an average dimension in relation to human size, which has led us to apply the word large to certain things and the word small to certain other things, only because the eye's weakness does not allow it to be aware of what is too immense or too tiny for it. Hence, it knows and sees almost nothing, and almost the entire universe remains hidden from it. The star that inhabits space, as well as the microbe that inhabits a drop of water. Color exists because the eye is constituted in such a way that it transmits to the brain, in the form of color, the various ways that bodies absorb and break down, in accordance with their chemical composition, the light rays that strike them. Let us examine the sense of hearing. Even more than with the eye, we are the playthings and dupes of this fanciful organ. Two bodies colliding produce a certain shock in the atmosphere. This movement makes a certain tiny piece of skin vibrate in our ear, which changes immediately into a sound. Something that is in fact nothing but a vibration. I imagined man without ears, suspecting the existence of sound as we suspect so many hidden mysteries. Man noting acoustic phenomena whose nature and provenance he cannot determine. And I grew afraid of the night. From the moment we can know almost nothing, and from the moment that everything is limitless, what remains? sense? Does emptiness actually not exist? What does exist in this apparent emptiness? And this confused terror of the supernatural which has haunted mankind since the birth of the world is legitimate. Since the supernatural is nothing other than what remains veiled to us. Then I understood terror. It seemed to me that I kept brushing against the discovery of a secret of the universe. I tried to sharpen my organs, to excite them, to make them perceive glimpses of the invisible. Often I thought an intangible hand, or rather an ungraspable body, was lightly grazing my hair. He didn't touch me, since it wasn't a carnal essence, but an imponderable, unknowable essence. One evening I heard the floor creak behind me. It creaked in a strange way. The next day, at the same time, the same sound occurred. I was so afraid that I got up. Certain that I was not alone in my bedroom. I could see nothing. The air was clear, transparent everywhere. Though, and often looked around. In my bedroom, a mirror. I looked at myself in it. My eyes looked strange, my pupils quite dilated. He was between us. He, the invisible one, and he was concealing me. It was like the end of the eclipse. What was hiding me had no outlines, but a kind of opaque transparency that little by little became clearer. And finally, I could see myself clearly, just as I do every day when I look at myself. I remained for hours, nights, days, weeks in front of my mirror, waiting for it. It does not come anymore. It has understood that I've seen it. But I feel that I will wait for it always, until death. That I will wait for it without rest, in front of this mirror, like a hunter lying in wait. And in this mirror, I'm beginning to see crazy images, monsters, hideous corpses, all kinds of terrifying beasts, atrocious beings, all the unlikely visions that must haunt the minds of madmen. That is my confession, my dear doctor. Tell me, what should I do?